Hello everyone, I'm Preeti Surya from the Department of Journalism and Mass Communication, and I'll be taking up 401 e-journalism with you for this semester. The first unit and the first topic that we'll be addressing is a brief history of the e-newspapers in English and Hindi, and we're also going to look at what are the reasons for the growth or the emergence of e-newspapers. So first, the definition. What is an e-newspaper? The electronic newspaper or e-newspaper is a self-contained, reusable and refreshable version of a traditional newspaper that acquires and holds information electronically. Moreover, electronic newspapers retrieve information electronically from online databases, process it electrically with word processor, desktop publishing packages and a variety of more technical hardware and software, and transmit it electronically to the end user. A remote access electronic newspaper is commonly called an electronic newspaper. An e-newspaper must fit the definition of both a newspaper and a remote access electronic serial, a serial publication containing news on current events of special or general interest issued in a machine-readable format and accessed via input-output devices connected electronically to a computer. E-newspapers are accessed most frequently via the internet. This definition will evolve as the concept of an online newspaper continues to evolve. E-newspapers are often associated with an existing newspaper in print. You will find that the broadsheet Times of India is exactly replicated in the e-version, and most e-newspapers do not have enumeration, though they do have chronology, and many maintain archives of back issues online. In the sense that if you want to access the old issue of Times of India, let's say of March 2020, you may be able to access it in the online version. So there is an archive of the e-newspapers of old editions. This definition excludes the home pages mounted by publishers. So for instance, rediff.com or msnindia.com or Times of India home page. Those are not what e-newspapers are. Teasers or advertisements for online papers. So whenever there is a video content, which is almost like an advertisement of an online newspaper, that is not what e-newspaper is. Worldwide websites that only compile news from external sources, online news services, dial-up bulletin board services, etc. So online newspaper or web newspapers, online editions of newspapers available on the web with special characteristics such as navigation support, advertisement and style of presenting the news. For example, the Hindu, the New Indian Express. Then PDF newspapers, which are electronic replicas of traditional newspapers. That is exactly what an e-newspaper is. E-news via e-devices. So Kindle, you may have an e-newspaper on the Kindle. So that is considered to be an electronic newspaper. And so electronic newspaper service supported by e-paper technology. For example, Hindustan Times on Kindle, that is what exactly the version of electronic newspaper. Although newspapers in electronic format first appeared in 1970s, online delivery of news emerged in the 1990s. Kerer and Mensing, 2006. In these early versions, the content was text-based and was delivered from online services such as America Online. Then in terms of evolution of new media, the 1990s and 2000, invention of the internet, birth of social networking sites and emergence of social media. All of this in terms of evolution of new media, dates back to 1990s to 2000s. Basically, this is the time frame where you really saw all these developments in the ICT front. 1991, World Wide Web came into being by Sir Timothy John Berners-Lee. 1995, Microsoft Internet Explorer was launched. In 1997, DVDs replaced VCR. In 2001, instant messaging services came into existence. In 2002, satellite radio was born. 2004, we saw the emergence of Facebook. 2005, again, was an important year because YouTube came into existence. 2006, Twitter hit the screens on the laptops. And 2007, Tumblr, and 2010, Instagram. So this is how the new media evolved. Essentially, I would want you to understand that a total of 5,786 online newspapers from 178 contributing countries are found to enrich the web. US proved to be a giant in terms of number of online newspapers, which is 2,402, accounting for 41.51% of the total. Canada and United Kingdom follows the list with 327, which which is 5.65%, and 306, which is 5.29%, newspapers respectively. India holds fourth position with a total of 260 or 4.49% of online newspapers. Now, 74% of the total online newspaper wealth is from high-income countries, followed by low-middle income, which is 12%, and upper-middle income, which is 11%, respectively. Low-income countries accounted a meager 2%. Right? So, here is a table which actually talks about the growth and, or which reflects the growth and development of the online newspapers. As we said in the text, United States of America, the maximum number of newspapers exist in the e-version. They alone account for 41.51% of the total online newspapers. Next comes the state-wise distribution of online newspapers. So, Maharashtra leads the Delhi, followed by Delhi and Gujarat. Right? And the statistics is right in front of you. Next, e-newspaper, a technological advancement to read and experience printed newspapers online, was available for 152 newspapers amounting to 58.46%. Newspaper sites which provide access to the back issues at least for 1 week were categorized under these papers with archive facility. And as such, a total of 155 papers provided access to the electronic archives. Besides, 41.54%, that is 108, provide both facilities, which is, there are basically, when I'm saying both facilities, I mean the broadsheet as well as the digital version. Indian newspapers started to host their content on web from the year 1996, and a big leap of over 300%, 328.57% to be precise, was observed in the year 1997. The year 2007 witnessed maximum number of newspapers, which amounts to 32. That flashed their content online, followed by the year 1998 and 2005 with 27 and 25 newspapers respectively. Overall, a compound annual growth rate of 28.29% is observed over a period of 14 years. Next comes the distribution of newspapers over years. So, as we see very clearly, in 1996, the digital or India footprint of e-newspapers, so the count was only 7, and as the statistics indicate here, in 2009, the same cumulative number stood at 246. Now, what I would really want you to understand here is, in terms of cumulative growth, 96 to 97 alone registered 328.57% of cumulative growth. So, now let me just give you one quick insight into what really contributed to the growth of the electronic newspapers. The main reason for their growth at a global level is directly proportional to the high rate of growth in GDP, which makes the high income countries to give a better output in terms of online newspaper wealth. However, a developing economy like India is doing excellently in the online newspaper market because India has also followed the voice, information for all. In addition, India has jumped on to big emerging market league. Furthermore, countries having high human development index. This index was actually coined by United Nations. This was called United Nations Human Development Index, in which net penetration was one of the criteria. So, countries having high human development index also excel in online newspaper market because a promising human development index takes into account how income is turned into better opportunity. There is also an app which is called e-papers. All e-papers can be found on this app, and it's one of the most user-friendly interface to access the newspapers. So people who access tabs or people who access Kindle can definitely look up for their newspapers or e-newspapers on this app. Thank you.